Hey guys, I'm Chani and you're watching The Art of Science. So if you're a subscriber, welcome back. If not, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. We know that some objects sink in water and some float. These two plastic boats have a density higher than water. So technically, they should sink, but they don't. In fact, they're not even floating. They are merely just sitting on top of the water. Confusing, right? Well, the scientific principle into play here is known as surface tension. Let's understand what it is. Water is made up of many molecules. All of these molecules are attracted to one another. They just want to bunch up together. And this attraction within the molecules is known as cohesion. Let's take this molecule for example. It is getting pulled by all the other molecules around it. So we have molecule A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Now A is getting pulled by B, but it is also getting pulled by C with an equal amount of force. So these forces cancel each other out. Similarly, each molecule inside the water is getting pulled in every direction with equal amounts of forces. These equal forces eventually cancel out and the molecules remain in the same position. But that's not what happens on the surface of the water, because the surface molecules don't have water molecules above them. And therefore, they are pulled inwards. This and the fact that they are comparatively free causes them to group together better. They form tighter bonds on the surface of the liquid, which kind of makes a skin for the liquid. This skin is what we call the surface tension. It is in this surface layer where the liquid is the strongest, and therefore it allows lightweight objects to sit onto it. Just like these plastic boards. Click on the link up here to check out how to make these boards and have your very own surface tension race at home. In fact, the hydrogen present in water molecules help them to bond so tightly that they give water a high surface tension. And you can use this to perform an amazing trick. The glass is upside down and yet the water doesn't fall out because of surface tension. I've linked the video up here. Did you know that soaps and detergents lower the surface tension of water, and this enables them to soak into the pores and holes of fabrics? In fact, it is this low surface tension that helps us blow bubbles. Yep, you heard that right. The soap molecules separate the water molecules from each other, and therefore, the gap between the molecules on the surface increases, which in turn causes the surface tension to decrease and allow the bubble to expand in size. You can use this hack to make differently shaped bubbles and bubble snakes too. I have linked the videos up here. Here's another really cool thing that you can do with surface tension. The common thing in all these experiments is the earbud dipped in soap. When this soap comes in contact with the surface of water, it reduces the surface tension of that area, causing all the water molecules and the other particles with it to be pushed on the sides. Do you think the same happens with milk as well? Click the link up here to check the video and let me know what you think happens in this experiment. Stay tuned for some more fun experiments that you can do at home with surface tension, and we'll see you next week.